Om Shanti. Avyakta Vartha, the 31st December 2003. 15th point. Merge it within you with the power to accommodate. If anything happens, then merge that in your inner mind by giving it to Bap Dada. First with the power to tolerate and then with the power to accommodate. If you have both these special powers in you, you will pass with honors. Keep this in an emerged form. The power to tolerate and the power to accommodate. Do not try to accommodate in such a way that you become sick, not like that. Some try to accommodate everything within themselves in such a way that they become sick. Their head is spoiled. Matha kharab. Do not accommodate inside yourself in that way. Merge it within you with the power to accommodate. This is a meeting with the teachers of Gujarat. This is a new year Mughli, and Baba is talking with the teachers of Gujarat. And he has given them certain homeworks. And after that he is saying, if anything happens, then merge that in your inner mind by giving it to Bap Dada. Baba is forewarning them that if anything happens, means something is going to happen. First with the power to tolerate and then with the power to accommodate. If you have both of these special powers in you, you will pass with honor. So keep this in emerged form, the power to tolerate and power to accommodate. Do not try to accommodate in such a way that you become sick, not like that. Some try to accommodate everything within themselves in such a way that they become sick. Their head is spoiled. Do not accommodate inside yourself in that way. Merge it within you with the power to accommodate. Baba is talking about two powers. What are they? First is power to tolerate and second is power to accommodate. We will discuss these two powers today. First is to tolerate. What to tolerate? Whom to tolerate? And how to tolerate? What to tolerate in this Brahmin life? Rude words. Aggressive behavior, inadvertent behavior, hostile behavior, unfamiliar behavior. Then, what to tolerate? What every Brahmin has to tolerate in this life? Defamation. People try to cast aspersion. People try to blame you, accuse you. People try to oppose you, criticize you. So many things they will do. And we cannot expect that they will say always good things about us. All these things are going to happen. Baba is saying, you should have the power to tolerate. What else you have to tolerate? Mistakes, blunders, non-cooperation. They don't cooperate sometimes. But you have to tolerate that. Then, what you have to tolerate? Criticism. Accusation, opposition, blame, mistrust, then untruth. Yes, sometimes you have to tolerate untruth. Because now, in this world, what is written in Mundaka Upanishad, Satyameva Jayate has become reversed. It is Asatyameva Jayate. But this Satyameva Jayate is not spoken of the outside world. It is spoken of the world of the soul. In the inner world, truth always wins. But outside world, we see that it is untruth which is winning everywhere. It is untruth that is getting success in this world. So, we should our faith in truth. Sometimes when that is challenged, we become intolerant. And what else to tolerate? These are few different things. We are not going to discuss these things because these things are already discussed in some other classes. We have to tolerate what? Opinions. Tolerate opinions of others. They have a different opinion. I have a different opinion. I feel think this thing should be done this way. They feel this should be done in this manner. I feel that this is Srimat and they feel, no, this is not Srimat, this is your Manat. And they feel this is Srimat. This conflicts, this differences of opinion, to tolerate them. This is very important aspect of Brahmin life. In outside world, they talk of religious tolerance. Suppose you worship Krishna and I worship somebody. So I can't tolerate. Devotees of Shiva don't tolerate devotees of Vishnu. There's a lot of conflicts. Religious intolerance is there in the world. And because of this religious intolerance and fanaticism, so many wars have been waged. So much bloodbath on the face of this earth. So outside world, it is religious tolerance. Within this Brahmin family, it is the difference of opinions. We differ from each other. So this difference of opinion, we have to tolerate. What is the way to tolerate that also we will see. But first, let us make the list of few things we have to tolerate. One is the difference, opinion. Second, okay, so that is the sort of, you have to tolerate your own physical pain. That is a different. That's on the physical level, mental level I'm talking of. What you have to tolerate? Sanskars. Their nature, their habits. One is sanskar, another is habits. They have such habits that you can't just stand them. You don't stand their habits. It's so difficult. You don't find that their sanskars are very much similar to us. They are absolutely out of harmony. The moment we are with them, there is bound to be conflict. Once a group of foreign teachers reached Dadi Janki, and they said that we are having a lot of conflicts. What to do? Dadi said, okay, you go and start your own new center. And Dadi said a very good thing there. It's better to have conflicts than attachment. It's better to have conflicts than attachment. This is a very revolutionary statement. It doesn't mean that you should have conflicts, but it is better to have conflicts than attachment. Because in attachment, where it ends, you never know. The journey of attachment and journey of conflicts. There are two journeys. One is the journey of conflicts, where you are always at loggerheads, at war with other. But this journey, you may patch up in future. But what about attachment? That knows no control. That attachment may turn into physical attachment. That attachment may land up into sensuality. All friendships, all attachments, all those attachments that start as seva, service or spiritual friendships, they ultimately turn towards sensuality. If that sword of knowledge is not there in between those two people. So Dadi had said, it's better to have conflicts than attachments. And I also totally agree with this. I would prefer to have conflicts than attachment. Detachment happens automatically when there is a conflict, and conflicts you can always patch up. But attachment, there's no cure. How to cure that attachment? That attachment goes on increasing and increasing and increasing. Anything happens to that person, you are hurt. If somebody speaks something to that person, you feel bad. If that person is in problem, you feel bad. If that center calls you, oh, I am having this problem, the person cannot sleep here. He is staying in Madhuban. But it becomes so difficult because he is attached to some sister or some brother outside. So this attachment is dangerous. Conflicts are okay. Conflicts and attachment both together. Actually, this will happen when there is attachment. When there are only conflicts, attachment are less likely. When there is an attachment, the deeper the attachment, there would be periods of conflicts in between. The person whom you love, you also want to scratch him, his face, and then again love him. You scratch him, you make him bleed, and then again you start loving him. This is what happens in conflicts. They can't leave each other, they can't live without each other. This is such a quagmire. This is such a mire. They are caught in that whirlpool of attachment, detachment, attraction, repulsion, hatred, love. Love-hate relationship it is known as. Friend at one time, enemy at another time. That's why in English there is a word frenemy. Phenemy. Phenemy is a word means the person who is your friend as well as your arch rival. Human mind is so controversial and so contradictory. It loves somebody and it also wants to hate somebody. At the same time, it hates that person. It is possessive, it becomes possessive of that person. If somebody else tries to get that person, you are at war. It is such a complex, such an intricate mind. So that is why what Dadi said to those group of teachers, it's better to have conflict than attachments. You can go and start your own new center. So, yeah, so many conflicts are there, rampant everywhere. So, but it doesn't mean that we are promoting conflicts. We are talking in comparison with attachments, deep attachments. Because those attachments turn into physical attachments. They have a tendency, a propensity to turn into physical attachments. And those physical attachments are the grossest form of body consciousness. Because they stimulate lust. Conflicts will not do that. This is one thing. So Baba is talking here about tolerate. So you have to tolerate opinions of others. You have to tolerate their habits. You have to tolerate their sanskars. These are the three important things you have to tolerate. Yeah? Yeah. Then there is little broader cultures. Yeah, that is different. Here we are talking of little different things. You have to, on a broader aspect, tolerate everybody's culture, everybody's sometimes language. Their language is rough. Their language is not gentle. That you have to tolerate. Now we'll straight away come to the important point of discussion, how to tolerate others. Rather than thinking more of what to tolerate, it's more important to decide, to formulate some answers for this, how to tolerate others. First of all, value differences. You need to understand that every human being is different. No two persons are similar, no two women are different, no two men are different. Some man has deceived you, some woman has deceived you, but that doesn't mean that all men are like that, all women are like that. That is why, always know that every human being is different, and in Brahmin family, everyone is special, everyone is unique, everyone is different, value their differences. This diversity has to be there. It cannot happen that everybody will have the same nature. So first is value differences. Second is try to understand them, or rather we can say empathize with them. Empathy. Empathize. Their outlook is different. Their perspective is different. They are trying to see things from a different point of view. I am trying to see things from a different point of view. Their ideas seem foolish to me, but they are as much real to them as my ideas are to me. That is why second is to empathize them. First is to value their differences. Or even before that we can say know the differences, then value their differences, and then empathize with them. Fourth, as sister said, try to know their background, their childhood, their cultural background. They must have been coming from some different religion. You do not know that at all. One, they had a very different childhood, very traumatic childhood. We never know that. They are brought up in a very different atmosphere. Very different life journey they had. So many hurts, so many incidences, post-traumatic stress disorder probably. They had such a stress in their life once. So they developed that post-traumatic stress disorder. They have passed through the very torment periods of life, very turbulent life, lot of depressions, and then lot of deceptions by near and dear ones. All those things have happened in their life, and after this they have reached here. And that is why we find that they don't trust anybody. We trust everybody, but they have doubts. Oh, this man will deceive me, this man will deceive me. Why they are having like this? Because their past life is like that. So try to understand the background, the backdrop, their lifestyle, their childhood, their parents, their upbringing, their sustenance, everything whatever that has happened in their life. Unless and until we know that, see, if you just think of this yajna, every soul has come here with a different purpose. Some souls have come here because they wanted to build up their relationships. They did not come to search God. They were not in search of God at all. Some came here just because their parents were in Gyan. Some came here because they were searching truth of life. Some came here because they wanted to learn meditation. That's it. Because they wanted their concentration of mind. That's why they came here. Some came here because they were fascinated, attracted by this red white dress. That's why they came. Some came here because they like this food here. This toli here. Some personality attract them. They got influenced by some speech by some person. They heard somebody on the television and they said, oh, this is awesome. Let me go and seek. So there are different reasons. There are few souls who were in search of God, madly in search of God. There are some people who were in depression and they came here and their depression got relieved. There were some people who were wandering from one place to another. They were not getting any destination and they got here. So if you see their background, they have come here for different reasons. There are some people who had lost some near and dear ones, and that's why they came here. There were some who wanted only truth. What is truth? There were some devotees who were going from one temple to another, one guru to another, one pilgrimage to another. So, if you see the background, it is so different. And how can I expect things from them? Before I start expecting anything from them, I need to understand them. This is the background. So, third point is this. Understand their background. Another is, analyze yourself. How to be tolerant of others is, analyze your intolerant feelings. What are those feelings wherein I am intolerant? I just can't stand. Somebody just walks inside the kitchen with dirty clothes and I can't stand that. What are those feelings which are there within me and I can't stand? Somebody speaking untruth, I can't stand. Some injustice is being done, I cannot stand. Intolerant. But what this intolerance has resulted into? Has it given me peace of mind? No, it hasn't. Rather, it made me all the more restive, all the more restless. So, analyze your intolerant feelings. What are the things I am intolerant? If suppose I ask somebody and somebody doesn't answer anything or answers rudely, do I become intolerant? If suppose somebody doesn't behave nicely with me or does something bad to me, do I become intolerant? If suppose you are made to sit here and give class, the moment you start giving classes, everybody walks out. Then, extremely sensitive nature and intolerance are also closely knit with each other. They go in tandem. So, there are many things that will generate this feeling of intolerance within us. Analyze your intolerant feelings. Another is to think of certain situations where you become intolerant. and analyze them, visualize them, envisage them, envision them in front of your eyes. Suppose this Kamlesh Bhai is sitting here. I don't like him. Okay? So this is one situation. I can't tolerate him. Now 10 people are coming and start praising him in front of me. Imagine this situation. They are saying this Kamlesh is so beautiful. He is awesome. He is so dedicated to his work. And I don't have very good experiences with him. I took books from him and he kept on calling, please give back my books, please give back my books. Once I took the book, I lost that book and he is after me all the time. Whenever I meet him, he is reminding me of that book. Oh, you lost that book, you lost that book. Bring me my book. So this is my feeling for him. And now 10 people are coming and saying, oh, this brother is so good. This is a difficult situation for me now. I already have a particular mindset for him. And now people are praising him. So imagine such situations where I am intolerant. This is just example. He is a good person, a very good brother. I am just telling, for instance. So it's like that. And suppose I am very much attached to him. Okay? I like him very much. He has helped me n number of times. And now many people come and they start opposing him. I will protect him. It's not like that. It is your biased. It is your wrong perception. It's your wrong viewpoint. Even if 10 other people tell me something of his mistakes, I will just ignore them. Those mistakes. I will not listen to their opinions. Because I am attached to it. So, these are two situations. One wherein I was attached. Another situation, I was little opposed to him. So imagine those situations in front of your eyes where you develop intolerant. You become intolerant. Suppose somebody is speaking untruth in front of your eyes. Untruth right under your nose. That time do I become intolerant? Suppose some injustice is being done on somebody. Do I become intolerant? Work on intolerance. Where I become intolerant. Suppose, Chandrasekhar Bhai, 10 people come and they say that we want to stay here for one day. And we had already informed you. And they have never informed. But they tell you that we have already informed you. Do I become intolerant? These all things will happen. All things will happen. There was one patient who called me up. Doctor, you are there. I am just coming. It's just 5 minutes to 1 o'clock. He says, I am coming. Just don't go. Wait for me. I am in coming. One sister called me. I am coming. I said, okay, I'll wait for you. So I waited. She never came. It was 1:30. I said, let me leave now. I can't wait anymore. Because she did not come. Evening, she met me. And no expression, no even discussion about that. All these things will happen. Yeah? Past is past. Past is past. But definitely you have to learn from everything. You have to learn from everything. They will call up at 11 o'clock at night. Are you there tomorrow? One brother called me at 2 o'clock. He said, I am having constipation since 3 days. He remembered that at 2 a.m. in the morning. I am an incarnation of tolerance. These are the self-respects you have to take. Tolerance, they are making me into a beautiful statue. So, you have to tolerate. Understand them, understand their feelings, emotions, be empathetic, try to be into their steps, into their shoes. Try to know what they feel, what they understand. Empathy. Know the differences, value the differences, understand the background, analyze your own intolerant feeling, and last is, imagine such situation in front of you. This is the situation. And do I remain intolerant in this tolerant in this situation? If no, then I am failed. Second power Baba talked of is power to accommodate. So many different sanskars. So many different sanskars. Not a single sanskar is like another person. Every sanskar is different. That's why it said that this entire Brahmin family is an examination hall and every Brahmin is a paper. Everyone is a paper. And you have to pass. Everyone is a teacher. Everybody is coming to teach you something. So, today's homework is these two. Work on the, as I told you, this last thing. Imagine those situations where you have where you become intolerant. Second, analyze your intolerant feelings and how to overcome them. Third, study their sanskars. Know that everybody is different. Everybody is different. This is not one-time job. Every day, every minute, every moment you have to revise. Because every moment you have somebody else, one paper in front of you. Every moment. And accommodate, try to accommodate all of these just as we are master oceans. Just as ocean accommodates everything within it. If you throw a flower, that also it accommodates. If you take a knife and if you throw on in the ocean, that also it accommodates. So, I have to accommodate everyone. I have to tolerate everyone. Why? Not because I am weak. Because it is God's order. That is why I have to tolerate. Nobody should take it for that I am weak, that's why I am tolerating. It's not like that. It is not that slavery mentality. It is because God's order it is. Om Shanti.